This is the Lock Picking Lawyer. The lock I have for you today is the Vink Haus 5-pin half euro cylinder that Corver 15 sent to me. Now, it's only a 5-pin lock, but it really does present some very interesting challenges. The first is a very difficult keyway. The second is some security pins in there, which I'll show you when we take it apart. But the real problem with opening this lock is the bidding. It is very, very extreme. So much so that I don't own a pick that can both navigate this warding and reach pin 4, which is the highest pin. So, what do you do in a case like this? Well, you have two choices. First is drill the lock, which is out, and the second is make your own pick. So, I got a piece of 12/1000ths 1095 feeler gauge and a pair of tin snips and some sandpaper, and I made this terribly ugly pick. It's actually thinned out from the 12/1000ths it started at. I guess this is at least 8 or 9 thousandths right now at the tip. It's a really a one-time use sort of pick, but it opens this guy up. So let's pick this guy open, hopefully, then we'll take it apart and I'll show you what's inside. I'm going to stick this little guy down here so I don't harm the lock as I pick, using a Sparrow's pry bar type tension wrench in the top of the keyway, and I'm going to start with my number 7 hook in 15/1000ths. Okay, nothing from 1, springy. Click out of 2. Little click out of 3. 4 is springy. Nothing from 5. Back to 1. Got a click out of him, dropped into a false set. Nothing from 2, nothing from 3, nothing from 4, and some counter rotation on 5. Okay, I think I got a click, but I might have dropped something in the process. Let's check our pins. 1, nothing there, nothing on 2, 3 dropped, lifting him back up. We got our false set back, nothing on 4. And let's see, where's 5? Okay, nothing on 5. So I think we're ready for our special pick. Let's move that over to, it's not easy to get in there, but okay, got a little click out of 3. Moving him back to 4. And let's see if we can get him number 4. There we go. Got it open. Okay, so it took a little bit of doing, a custom pick, but we did get this Vink Haus open. Now, let's take it apart and see what's inside. Okay, I did not take the clip off of this yet. Let's see if we can do that. Uh-oh. Okay, clip is off. Having a tough time getting our little tool in there. Okay, and I guess we're going to need to push this little pin out as well. There we go. Okay, we should be able to pull this straight out now. Let's see how that works out for us. Okay, worked out nicely, actually. Let's get these pins secured. Okay, let's start with our key pins. Standard, 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 and standard. And in the process of dropping them, one of the anti-drill pins fell out. I'll put that guy back. And if we take a look at this core, you'll see three ball bearings on this side and two on the other. They are passive pins designed to engage the little holes in the side of the key, strictly for key control. Now let's take a look at the rest of the pins here. Okay, one is standard. Two is standard. Three is, not sure what to call that, I guess a modified standard. Four is a spool. And five is a spool. Okay. Let me give you a close-up of the pins in this Haus Euro profile cylinder. All of our key pins are standard, although number three, it looks like, has a little narrowing on the end. And then driver pins one and two are standard. Number three is a modified standard. And then four and five are spools for a very long concave spool. Number four is the one that was giving us the most trouble. Now, moving over to the core. Very interesting. I mean, it looks like we actually have some filing on that. Usually don't see that in the higher quality locks. And then on the sides, we have some ball bearings. Those are our passive pins. And that's on both sides. So, that is it for our Haus Euro profile cylinder. The real show here is the bidding on that key. Absolutely dastardly. Very hard to deal with. I had to make a custom pick, but we got her open. If you have any questions or comments, please put them below. If you like this video and would like to see more like it, please subscribe. And as always, have a nice day. Thank you.